Hey, I'm Zansi Crew. Yes, guys, sometimes I wonder if South Africans on Twitter will ever see the gates of heaven. Hello and welcome to Entertainment News from Zansi. Now, if you're new to the channel, you know you love the stories, go ahead, click the subscribe button and the bell, and you'll never miss an update. So, guys, Lasizwe Tambuza led social media into his mourning process during the final send-off of his father, Menzi Mthunu. And let's just say that social media was less than happy about that. The YouTube sensation lost his father and laid him to rest on Friday. Now, on his father's passing, Lasizwe was in Cape Town with his siblings, which included beloved media personality Kanye Mbao. Now, while Kanye has opted to mourn her father's passing in private and away from the public eye, Lasizwe, on the other hand, has just made it clear that he will mourn the loss with the camera lens in hand to make sure that his social media stays having content. Now, the latest set of images that Lasizwe decided to gift his followers were those of the final moments he shared bidding farewell to his father. In a series of images, Lasizwe showcases how immense it looked like to say goodbye to his father. While the images paint the popular YouTuber, it was not long after posting the images that tweets and Instagrammers dragged a baby boy for displaying his most vulnerable moments. Now, the biggest drag that people on social media dragged him for was the choice of images he decided to share on his timeline. In all the images that Lasizwe managed to decide they need to go on social media, he is on the verge of crying, already crying, or has allegedly saved a tear on his cheek for the camera. Now, people went in on the images suggesting that Lasizwe had specifically told the cameraman to snap only when he sees a tear. Now, the second came as a result of his outfit and styling choices. Now, all the siblings had opted to dress in white to be carefully distinguished amongst all the rest of the mourners. Lasizwe, however, opted for a custom-made suit by a go-to designer. Lasizwe is already known for questionable outfit choices. However, what confused many was how could he copy and paste an outfit by Billy Potter and think that it's not going to make headlines. Another aspect of the outfit that many gave the side eye was his shoe choice. Now, the last point of the styling that many wondered about was the inspiration of the nails. Throughout the whole procession, Lasizwe had his manicured, normal-looking nails, okay, that we know. However, when it was time to bid farewell at the graveside, Lasizwe opted to shake the table by adding talon on the hand that was in view of the camera. He then outstretched the hand and just in time for the cameraman again to get the snap and the angle. Now, after realizing that he was being dragged, Lasizwe responded on Twitter. He defended himself with a line that had weight, but was explaining that life isn't a group assignment. He said, "Some people tend to forget we mourn differently and life isn't a group assignment. If I choose to mourn on social media, respect my wishes. I social media yam lena." Namzansi, you know I love to hear from you. So let me know what you think of this on the comment section below. But for now, you know I will bring you the stories hot, just the way you like them.